This isn't bacon plant-based rashers, it says. I think this is trying to be some sort of vegan bacon. I don't know where I got this information from, but ages ago, someone said to me that the most common thing that turns vegans back into meat eaters is the smell and taste of bacon. And then, funny enough, only about a couple of years ago, I was speaking to my manager and she was saying our vegan friend had a apparent night off of being a vegan. And she was bought for her a bacon sarnie and she loved it. Well, anyway, moving swiftly on. Hey, I think that's meant to be some sort of either colloquialism or some attempt at over-friendliness. We're Andy and Pete, and we made this, in all capital letters, I don't know why. I should have got my tripod out for this bit, I'm a bit shaky, sorry. FYI, oh, I hate that when people say FYI. Our last job entailed selling tons, literally tons of meat. Why do they have to put literally tons in brackets? I mean, if you're selling a food product, then you're going to be selling a lot of it probably anyway. Anyway, then we felt bad. Well, why? You've already sold all that meat. Why did you feel bad? That's just annoying. Also, we felt as if. Meat alternatives weren't really, that must have fallen asleep on the L key. For people who love the taste of meat, we felt like meat alternatives weren't really for people who love the taste of meat. Let me just digest that. We felt like, it's bugging me because they've put like instead of as if. Meat alternatives weren't really for people who love the taste of meat. Oh, I see what they mean, yeah. We, in capital letters, you know what, if they made this, they shouldn't have written this. We felt that they were for people who liked sandals with socks. Well, no one should like people with sandals with socks, because that's just stupid. Is it anything worse than the three S's when you see people wearing that, shorts, sandals and socks? So we've basically ended up making food for ourselves. But we'd love you to nom nom it too. This! Why are the capital letters? This is a game changer. Great for you and the planet. Oh, well, that's debatable. Is any of this stuff actually better for the planet? Because so often it isn't. And you won't notice the change. Well, that's a big claim there, isn't it? You won't notice the change. This has to now taste exactly the same as bacon. And I somehow doubt it. Exactly the same. Exactly the same. Anyway, there's pictures at the end so you can see what's in it and what's not in it. Enough yakety-yak, let's get cooking this exactly how it's said, with a teaspoon of oil. At £2.95 from Waitrose, and it says on the back as well, packed in the UK for this. You see, that's a bit elusive, isn't it? I mean, does that mean it's not made in the UK and the mailer just did this and put that in there and said, okay, it's been packed? You know, and proper bacon probably would be made in the UK and I'd have all the flags on it and this, that and the other and say British and this, that and the other. Whereas this sort of stuff's probably non-regulated. And the comment I made about it being maybe not as good for the environment is because of that being one of the reasons. I mean, where did they ship it in from? I mean, if it had to be barged in from the continent... Oh, I better get this going, hadn't I, before I open it. Actually, that's a teaspoon, maybe a little bit more, but I don't think too much is more. And then we'll go. Oops, is that the wrong one? Yes, it is. There we go. Right. Now, if you can smell this, future YouTube, it does smell of smoked bacon, but not of real bacon sort of smell. It's not quite there, but if you was to smell this and just in passing, you'd be like, oh, it's cooking bacon. Have a good smell. It's got a lot more of a, now that I've opened it, it's got a lot more of a smoky sort of smell, which is even less like bacon. Yes, I know that I'm sounding really negative right now, but it's just the fact that, yet again, it's another meat item that's supposed to taste of bacon. Wow, that's a rasher, apparently. Okay, then. Very small. Okay, they're very small. I was expecting at least, I thought that was going to be the width of it, and it's not. So whilst I'm waiting for my oil to get a bit hotter, I'm going to wash my hands. And maybe get a bit of bread and butter going. No, I'm just going to try it on its own, because I want to know what it tastes like. Got a bit of a yellow flame there. Bit of carbon monoxide. Delicious. That's a joke, obviously. Carbon monoxide is obviously very dangerous. It says cook for a couple of minutes or until crispy. So that's what I'm going to do. I think the oil is just to make it spit so you can injure yourself like genuine bacon. Little bits everywhere. This, do you think it smells like bacon, or do you think it just... No, do you think it smells like bacon?
Yeah, it's got a little smell of bacon. More bacon-y than something else.
Play it out. I'm going to get us some forks, and we'll try this.
And here we are, two garden forks.
Got to get out of the bloody pan now. Come on.
It was a non-stick pan. Can I help you?
Yeah.
Oops.
Is it on?
Yep.
Play it over.
Oh, thank you.
There you
go. Ow.
There you go. Sorry, was that hot?
Yes. A bit bland.
Mate, isn't it? It doesn't taste of anything. It's all smell.
Well, actually, it tastes of a little bit of fish.
It does, actually, yeah. Mm. You're right.
I mean, it's not dislikable.
But that's even more weird because it's meant to be vegan. It says on here, so it shouldn't taste of fish. Water is the first ingredient, so I've paid £3 for water. Soya protein concentrate, 22%. That means a lot of this is water. Soya protein isolate, oh, that sounds delicious. Flavouring, that could mean anything. That means you can put absolutely anything under the name flavouring. Pea protein isolate. Vegetable extracts. From radish, carrot and paprika, potato starch, salt, rapeseed oil, maltodextrin, iron. And that's what's in it.
I've got to be honest, if you put this in between two pieces of bread, like a bacon sandwich,
yeah,
I'd be quite happy with it.
Well, let's do that.
It's
because
it's got enough flavour to carry it.
Are you sure? Because I can't taste anything. And that's not because of the woohoo flu.
Oh, I can. So, we can...
Yeah, but... You can tell it's not bacon though, can't you?
Oh yeah.
Get this buttered up. Butter. Peanut butter jelly. Peanut butter jelly. Peanut butter jelly and a baseball bat. Utterly butterly. Spread on some nice tiger loaf. Let's try it in a butty. Right. So that's it. There we go. It does smell nice, but so far I'm not blown away with the flavour.
Okay. I must admit, it looks a little bit like sliced fish.
It is weird how it's got a bit of a fishy texture, isn't it? That's asbestos fingers, there we are. Oh, that was very hot. Right. Let's cut this in half, because I don't feel like I want a full thing of this to myself. Right. Right. I'm going to put a bit of tomato sauce in, man.
I'll go without the sauce and then we can see how it compares.
Alright, then when you try yours now, then I'll just put
it's my sauce in my left hand. One with the poison or the right one?
Ha ha.
Okay.
This is not Alice in Wonderland. These one half's not going to make you bigger, the other half's going to make you smaller.
It's quite pleasant.
Mmm. Does it taste better in bread? With butter. That's not. The butter is obviously not vegan, so we've had to vegetarianise so far the bacon.
Well, look, let's be honest. It's not exactly bacon, but it's a very pleasant taste.
Because you would eat bacon sort of things with tomato sauce, wouldn't you? Or bran sauce.
I usually have tomato.
And here's Margot. I've got to admit, it just smelled a bit better now we've put it in bread for some bizarre reason.
What do you think?
It's not bacon. I've got to remember it's not bacon. I know that's the name of it, but...
No, I mean, the whole point, this is, if you're a meat eater, you'll probably eat real bacon. If you like the taste of it, but you're not a meat eater, then it's a good substitute.
No, that's a bone of contention with that, though. If you decided to go vegetarian, if you decided to go vegan, why are you still eating meat products that are meant, or products that are meant to imitate meat?
Well, hold on. All it says is you shouldn't eat animal meat. I mean, it doesn't say anything about flavouring, Charlie, or texture. It's a non-meat product.
I know, but it passively alludes to it that it is. Especially on the back, because I've read the back.
So what puts you off this?
It's got so little flavour.
You see, I disagree with you. You've got a lot more flavour than I was expecting.
I've eaten it all because it's a review. This is where people say, hey, you don't like it, but you're still eating it. Well, yeah, because it's a review.
It's not perfect, but I think it's acceptable. And I'm a meat eater.
Well, obviously I am. And then for £3, though, and we've pretty much eaten half of it already.
Yeah, but...
And... Give me proper real bacon any day. I do like plenty of meat alternative products. I do like Linda McCartney sausages. They're amazing. I'm not fond of this at all. I've tasted better meat alternative products. What do you think?
I'd be happy to have it. So we disagree, which is very...
So nice. You'd buy this again?
I'd buy that again, yeah.
I wouldn't. So there you go. That's the review. I won't get her again, but Sherlock would.
Bye-bye, viewers.
Bye. Scrass, spell me. Bye. I think I'll wash it down with a nice Chianti. Mmm.